It's time to replace this thin, awful butt pad on the back of the Boyds Pro Varmint stock. We're going to put on a Pachmayr Decelerator. And what we have to do first is get this thing off, which sounds like it should be easy, but last time I tried to remove this thing, it did not want to go anywhere. Now, what I've done is I've gone ahead and put just a little bit of grease on the two screw points right here, and I put a little bit of grease on the screwdriver as well, because we don't want to tear this thing up. We want this to be as painless a removal as possible, just in case we do have to put this thing back on or something. But yeah, let's go ahead and unscrew this. Both of these screws are now loose, but this thing is still going nowhere. It really feels like it's glued in place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop this into the vise, and I'm going to see if I can maybe tap on this to remove it. I didn't even have to do any tapping. Check this out. All I had to do was just chuck this thing in the vise, and yeah, it's pretty obvious there was a little something stuck to the backside of this, but popped right out. Ta-da! One of the things that I'm anxious to figure out is if the screw spacing is the same on this butt pad as on this one. I'm really hoping so, because this thing is pre-drilled, and I'd rather not have to bust any new holes in this. So I've gone ahead and I've stuck the screws through. Dun da da da! It fits! Okay. So all we have to do is we can use these same screws that, we can use the screws that originally came with this Boyds pad, or we can use the new ones. I'm pretty sure the exact same thing. Same thread pitch and all that. I'm gonna check them out and see if there actually are any differences. But yeah, we should be pretty good to go on this one. Now, one thing that we have to do next, this side of the pad probably has no cuts in it. There's actually no way to get the screw inside this side of the pad, so we're going to have to cut our own holes. So what we have to do is use kind of a pin punch from the back side so we can kind of get through the face. We'll use a razor blade, cut a little cross where the screw goes through, and that should do it. All right, instead of poking a hole through this to begin with, what I'm going to do here is I just put the screw inside the screw hole in the back. And you can see when I press down, it starts to poke up the correct spot right here. So what I'm going to do is just take a little chalk, and there we go. Now I know where the center point is on this. I just have a tiny little white dot. It's kind of hard to see in this light, but I have a tiny little white dot. So now all I have to do is plunge in the knife. And if I pull, I can start to see the hole opening up. I'm gonna have to make this just a little bit bigger so that the screw can pass through nicely without tearing things up. This right here is the secret to having a really pretty butt pad on the end. This way the screw can go through, nothing gets torn up, and if everything goes right, no one will even be able to tell that this is held on by screws or where they can find the screw holes. Pretty cool. In preparation for inserting these screws, I've gone ahead and put a little bit of grease right over those holes that we just cut. And I'm going to put some grease around the head of the screw too, since we just don't want to tear this thing up. We want it to be as pretty as possible. All right, here's the moment of truth. I have pushed the screws far up to the head, and I have some junk in the grease on my screwdriver. Anyway, gonna push this in, and it should just pop right over. Okay, and look at that. nice and smooth. There's a little bit of grease around where the head was, but yeah, looking good. Now for the rear, or the bottom one. Okay, looking nice. My task from now on is to access those screws as seldom as possible. Every time that I insert the screwdriver, it's going to tear things up just a little bit more. So I'll try to do as few passes as I need to. But I do need to attach this to the rifle first so I can get an idea of the shape that we're going to sand this down. The size that we selected was medium, and you can see that there's plenty of meat around where the stock goes. So we're going to have to mark this off. We're going to have to make a line on this kind of hard section of the butt pad to show the do not cross line, and we'll be able to do our coarse sanding using a belt sander. All right, I'm going to use this handy dandy Exacto knife, and I am going to trace the shape that I need to cut in this pad. And this is a very sharp knife, so I need to be careful not to actually cut into the wood. Done. I did nick it a couple times, but not bad. I'll just be using a simple belt sander here. I removed the screws entirely. I'm going to have to flip the work over to check my marks every so often. And yeah, I'll just be using this to very quickly make that shape. Here's the result. This is going to get us pretty close to the final dimensions. We're going to use some sandpaper on a block to finish this off. You can see that here I did start to get into the structure of the pad here. So it looks like there's a metal lining around the edges here. So I'll have to do something to kind of mask that. So for those of you that are wanting to put a recoil pad on the Boyds Pro Varmint stock, the medium size decelerator might be a bit too big for you. You might want to go for the small size. I think that can be pretty easily fixed though. We'll see how that goes.
I placed a ring of blue tape around my stock to protect the finish, and then I installed the butt pad. So this is ready to take down to its final level. I'll be using sanding blocks to kind of smooth this down, and I'll be able to see if I start wearing into the tape here as I get closer. The tape comes off, and here's the result. Just because of the thickness of the tape, there's still just a tiny bit of a hump going into the wood here. So I have a choice at this point whether I want to sand this absolutely flush with the wood and actually cut into the wood just a little bit and then re-polyurethane this, or stick with really this pretty invisible lip that I can only just feel. It's up to you to decide what you want to do at this point. I opted for a nice smooth transition, so what I did is I taped off the rubber part of the butt pad back here, and that should help keep a lot of this smearing that we're seeing off the wood. And I'm going to go ahead and make a nice perfect transition from this kind of plastic base to the wood, so that when this is done I shouldn't feel any dip. I will have to put some polyurethane again on this this back section, but the end result is going to look really good. I put on three coats of polyurethane
And time to take the tape off this thing. Looks like the tape is going to help me clean it. All right, there it is. I still need to fix this this gap where I started cutting into the plate that's inside this. But yeah, aside from that, it's looking pretty good.